Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to build the fire sensor. So in this video, we are going to go over all the parts required for the fire sensor, and then we're going to make it. To start off with the parts, we're going to need two 2-pin PCB terminals, one 4-pin female header, one 3-pin male header, one 2-pin jumper, one 5-volt to 3.3-volt regulator, one 10K resistor, one 330-ohm resistor, one 1K resistor, one PC817 optocoupler, one ESP8266, one custom fire sensor PCB, more on that later, one plastic enclosure, two conductor 22-gauge cable, male USB connector, and a 5-volt USB wall adapter. The wall adapter can be any USB 5-volt adapter, like a phone charger. For tools, we are going to need a soldering iron with ST7 tip, flux, steel wire, solder, wall tack, PCB holder, helping hands, wire strippers, small wire cutters, small flat screwdriver,
and a hot glue gun.
That is everything that we will need. The links to all the parts and tools will be over on my website. Link is in the description. On my website, you will also find the kit for this device. So instead of buying all these parts separately, you can buy one kit and get all the parts fast and at the same time. There's even an option to get the device assembled. So all you have to do is install its software and set it up. In the beginning, I did say custom circuit board because to make this easier, I designed a custom circuit board so that way not only will it be very stable and have strong connections with no guesswork in assembling it, but also so I can make many of them really easily for my house. I have provided the Gerber file on my website as well as where to get it made. You can also buy the PCB on my website, which is the easiest and fastest way to get them. Since all the connections are already made on the circuit board, all we have to do is solder the components onto the board. First, let's take the circuit board and put it into the circuit board holder. If you look closely at the circuit board, you will see that there are labels next to the component slot. When I say where to put the component, that is what I will be referring to. I like to solder from the less sensitive components to the most sensitive. So let's start off with a 2-pin terminal. Take the terminals and put them in J3 and J4, then solder them in. If you want to know how to solder or how I solder, then check out my guide for the door sensor, because in that video, I went over it in detail. Next, take the 4-pin female header and put it into J2 and solder in. If the leads get long and stick out, cut them with wire cutters. Then take a strip of the male header and using the wire cutters, make a header that is 3 pins long. Take that 3-pin male header and solder into J1. For slot U2, take the 5-volt to 3.3-volt regulator and match up its leads to the board and solder it in. Next, take the 1K resistor and solder into slot R3. To put the resistor in the slot, you have to bend its leads so that way they are parallel to each other. After that, take the 330-ohm resistor and solder into slot R2. Finally, take the last resistor, which is the 10K resistor, and solder in. The last component on the top of the PCB is the PC817 optocoupler, and it gets soldered into slot U3. But when you put it in the slot, make sure you align the circle on the optocoupler with this square silver pad on the PCB. Before we flip over the PCB, we are going to put the 2-pin jumper on the 3-pin male header and above the PGM side. Great, now we have one component left to solder, and that is the ESP8266. It is on the back of the PCB, so flip it over. I recommend putting flux on every single pad of the ESP8266 and of the circuit board, and then solder it in. Next, we're going to work on the power cable to the device. I am talking about the 5-volt power cable. First thing we have to do is take the 2-conductor 22-gauge cable and cut it to length. I cut mine to the length of 10 feet. Then take one end of the wire and strip it to expose the 2 conductors. Strip a little of each conductor and then take the wire boot and plastic boot of the USB connector and slide it over the 2 conductors. Next, take the helping hands and put the 22-gauge wire in one of them and the USB connector in the other. Then solder the black wire to the far left pin and the red wire to the far right pin. Now put some hot glue on the connector and slide over the plastic boot and the wire boot. If you want, you can connect the USB to the 5-volt wall adapter, but do not plug it into the wall. Almost done. Strip the other end of the 22 gauge cable and then loosen the two screws on the 2-pin terminal above the 5 volts. Then take the red wire and put it into the hole parallel to where it says plus, and the black into the hole above the minus symbol, and tighten the screws. You can now put the PCB into the enclosure, but do not put on the lid. That is it for the hardware of the actual device. Now all it needs is some software, which will be in the next video. Alright, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below, or head over to mksmarthouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of getting answered. Goodbye.